So, if you would, tell me your name, occupation, and then our location.
My name is John Mussington. I'm an educator by profession, marine biologist, gardener, master of all trades. Right now we're located in Barbuda. This is the Sir McChesney Secondary School. It's the only secondary school on Barbuda, basically equivalent to high school.
So what happened here in Barbuda?
Well, we're just recovering from Hurricane Irma that struck on the 6th of September. It was a category 5++ when it made landfall in Barbuda. The eye passed directly over us. So we got a lot of devastation. Quite a number of houses which were torn off, and the school essentially was damaged minimally.
Okay. So what are we building over there?
Well, right now, in preparation for restarting the school, the agricultural program took a hit in terms of our farm, poultry, crops. We took a hit in terms of total devastation in that. So in order to get school back up and running, the agricultural program, which is the core of our curriculum, we need to get that up and started first. So what we're going to be doing is doing some experiments with the garden pool in terms of getting a shade house in terms of high intensity crop production. So we're looking for a garden pool in terms of transferring that technology. And so going from there, we'll be doing two things. It will be supplementing our normal agricultural program, but we are going to be diversifying in terms of the technology. Barbuda is limited in terms of rainfall, so it's drought prone. Most of the water, in fact all of the water that we use here at the school is rainwater harvested. We have a 60,000 gallon cistern, and that meets all of our needs for agriculture, drinking, cooking, washing, cleaning, everything. So we believe that the technology in terms of aquaponics is the way to go in terms of minimum water use and maximization of production. Now with the garden pool system, what we anticipate is that we will have intensive culture of cash crops, cash vegetables, which are a challenge to grow under the normal technology. So in using this, we hope we can actually supplement our farms and actually teach the technology to our children.
Cool. So how will this help you, Barbuda, and others?
Well, it would help in terms of allowing the children coming up to realize that agriculture does not have to come to an end, living on an island which is going to be impacted by climate change. We anticipate we're going to be getting more storms. The rainfall no longer is predictable. We're going to get periods of drought, and under those circumstances, traditional agriculture is going to be a challenge. So using this technology, we can actually find a means of continuing to grow crops, but using this technology in terms of the shade house and the aquaponics. So teaching the children that technology, they can actually proceed when they leave school to earn a livelihood using this. As well as it also provides us with an income in terms of the school. We can learn from our past experience, because when we started doing poultry, before that, all of the eggs coming into Barbuda came from overseas. But within the space of 3 years in our poultry program here at the school, we literally provided all the eggs that are consumed in Barbuda. So what we hope to do is to follow that model, now that we know that it is possible. And we'll do the same in terms of fresh green vegetables. Okay.
So what do you think about Garden Pool, the organization?
Well, Garden Pool, just got to know them. And essentially, I'm really blown away by the technology that they're using. The key thing that stood out for me in terms of what Garden Pool is doing is the whole concept of keeping it simple, keeping it natural. Once you can get as close to nature as possible, because we have an aquaponics system, but the route we started was the hard technology, high volume pumps and that sort of thing. It took a while for us to get that functioning in Barbuda, and a lot of things we learned was that the hard technology has a way of breaking down, and it's not 100% suited to the conditions. What works is what you actually figure out in terms of your particular condition. And I love the flexibility of Garden Pool in that they have used the approach of actually trial and error and finding out what works and keeping to natural systems as close as possible. So that's the route we're hoping to go down.
So how do you think others that are watching this can help?
Well, others, for Barbuda in particular, right, we're at the stage that we're going to have to apply the technology. And it's something that we're going to have to work out to suit the conditions. So having it in the school will give children exposure, and then hopefully they will actually learn the technology, learn the process, and begin to experiment themselves. And there is where you're going to get forward motion, because the more people fiddle, the quicker the solutions will come. And once you begin to share solutions, then you can only go forward.
So I got a question that people ask me a lot. What is resilience to you?
Well, resilience and the Barbudan culture go hand in hand. Barbuda is not an easy island to live on. It's flat, soil intensities are quite high, it's a limestone, so the soils are very thin. So for you to be able to practice agriculture here, you have to be able to figure out what works. And resilience is all about trying things and working out the solutions so that you can move forward. And it's about not giving up and finding those little things and the way to do things efficiently so that you can continue surviving. We are going to be faced with the challenges of climate change. We have already started seeing it, right? Traditional agriculture was basically slash and burn. The technology that they've worked out over hundreds of years is something that worked under the conditions, and it incorporates the biochar technology. The burning will add certain minerals and so on to the soil, but it's the science behind it is really fascinating. Resilience is all about taking those methods and building upon them in order to move forward, to be able to survive. Okay? And that's what Barbuda has always been about.
Very good. Is there anything else you feel you want to say?
Well, just from 2013 coming forward, we realized that the only way to survive on Barbuda is to embrace the technology, and it has to be a mixed with local traditional knowledge with the science fine-tuned to come up with solutions, and I believe that's the way.